Mommy got sick. And it happened just like that. There's nothing anybody could do. It isn't fair. There's no reason. But if we start asking why, we'll go crazy.
5 minutes in the microwave, any one of them, 5 minutes and done. Ready to eat. Do you know how to make juice?
Microwave, 5 minutes. Here. My shrink. Colin.
Loss of spouse, support group. Chicago Cancer Family Network. Parents without partners, partners without parents. Hug yourself. Hug a friend, hug a shrink, or work. Work hard. Work will save you. Work is the only thing that will see you through this. Don't mind him. He's just a guy who's lost his wife. What I think we really need is change.
Good idea. Take a couple of weeks off, get some sun, take Jonah fishing.
You know, a real change. A new city. Some place where every time I go around a corner, I don't think of Maggie.
Where are you gonna go?
I was thinking about Seattle.
Eventually, in a few months, you'll start seeing women. You'll meet someone.
Right, right. Move on. Right. That's what I'm gonna do. And then in a few months, boom, I'll be fine. I'll just grow a new heart.
Sam, I'm sorry. She didn't mean that.
I know, I know. Look, it just doesn't happen twice.
You must remember this. A kiss is still a kiss. A sigh is just a sigh. The fundamental things apply as time goes by. And when two lovers woo, they still say, I love you. On that you can rely. No matter what the future brings, as time goes by. Moonlight and love songs never out of date. Hearts full of passion, jealousy and hate. Woman needs man, and man must have his mate. That no one can deny. It's still the same old story, a fight for love and glory, a case of do or die. The world will always welcome lovers as time goes by.
The tall one with red hair is your cousin Irene.
You'll recognize her by the disappointed look on her face.
I was married to Harold, who ran off with his secretary.
But came back because Irene threatened to put the dog to sleep if he didn't.
Brother Dennis is Professor Johns Hopkins. He's married to, Betsy.
The most competitive woman in the world.
I don't see how I'm gonna remember all this.
Oh, well, Walter, you will.
Your Uncle Milton lost all of his money.
And some other people.
In a pyramid scheme. Don't mention the IRS or the federal prison system. Your mother's Barbara, your father's Cliff.
My father has electric trains.
Really? Am I what they had in mind?
Oh, Walter, they're gonna love you.
Everybody, Annie has an announcement.
Oh.
Walter and I are engaged.
Sneezing in a time like this.
This is a very important moment for me.
But he's allergic to everything. Don't worry about it.
Bees. I'm allergic to bees.
Harold is allergic to every type of bee. We always have to carry a hypodermic of adrenaline wherever we go.
If he eats even one tiny piece of a nut,
my head swells up like a watermelon and I drop dead.
It's the same with Harold and bees.
Your mother and I had salmon at our wedding, and I really think that a wedding without cold salmon is...
I'm not allergic to salmon.
Oh, he's not allergic to salmon.
I don't think. But you never know.
You never know.
Harold wasn't always allergic to bees.
Oh, honey, what a shame. We had some champagne, and what did we use it for?
Uncle Milton's parole, and it was delicious. Oh.
It was, wasn't it, Milton? No.
When are you getting married, Annie?
In early June, in the garden.
Does it have to be in the garden?
Walt, what about Harold and bees?
I'm allergic to bees.
We'll spray you.
Cold salmon, a lovely cucumber salad, strawberries.
I'm afraid I am allergic to strawberries.
Is this all right with you, Walter?
Today, I consider myself the luckiest
The Lou Gehrig line. Remember, Dad, the Lou Gehrig line from
Pride of the Yankees.
Pride of the Yankees.
Pride of the Yankees.
Yeah.
Baseball. It's baseball. Historical reference.
I would like to propose a toast.
Here, here.
Here, here.
To my kid sister.
To Walter and my baby.
Walter. To Walter and Annie. You're so good. Everyone, please eat before it gets cold. Here it is. The Historical Society wanted this, and I never would give it to them.
Oh, Mom.
I notice these things are back in fashion.
Grandmother's dress.
Oh, honey. Oh. He's a lovely man, Annie.
I know. He is wonderful, isn't he? And he's such a wonderful athlete.
Are his folks nice?
You'll love them. We're going down to D.C. tonight to be with them Christmas morning.
How did it happen?
Silly, really. I mean, I'd seen him at the office. Obviously, I'd seen him. He's the associate publisher. And then one day, we both ordered sandwiches from the same place, and he got my lettuce and tomato on whole wheat, which, of course, he was allergic to. And I got his lettuce and tomato on white.
How amazing.
It is, isn't it? You make a million decisions that mean nothing, and then one day, you order takeout, and it changes your life.
Destiny takes a hand.
Mom. Destiny is something we've invented because we can't stand the fact that everything that happens is accidental.
Then how do you explain that you both ordered exactly the same sandwich except for the bread? How many people in this world like lettuce and tomato without something else like tuna?
Well, it wasn't a sign. It was a coincidence.